I just spoke with a couple that is trying to conceive, and they had many questions regarding ejaculation frequency. And this is what I will talk about today. I am Dr. Anupama Deenadayal Mettler, a gynecologist and an embryologist. We are at Mamata Fertility Hospital's andrology lab. Now let's go into a few basics, very few. Every day, millions of sperm are produced in the testis. These sperm enter the epididymis, and here they are stored for anywhere from 2 to 11 days, where they undergo changes to become more mature. When a man ejaculates, a part of the sperm is always released from these mature sperm. And did you know that a man ejaculates anywhere from 20 to 120 million sperm in every ejaculation? So let's look now at a sample of a man who has not ejaculated for 20 days. As you can see here in the video, there are many sperm in the field. That is, his count is good. But do you notice that very few of them are moving? Now, what does this mean? This means that this man, because he hasn't ejaculated in 20 days, the sperm was stored in the epididymis. Now, when the sperm is stored in the epididymis beyond a particular number of days, reactive oxygen species start acting on these sperm and damaging them. And that is why you see that there are not many motile sperm, not many sperm that are moving. Along with this, these reactive oxygen species are affecting the DNA inside the sperm, which goes to the embryo or the child. Now, this damaged DNA is called DNA fragmentation, and there's an increased DNA fragmentation. It is known through various studies that when the abstinence is more than 4 days, that is, a man hasn't ejaculated for more than 4 days, his DNA fragmentation index increases. Now let's look at the sperm of the same man with only 2 days of abstinence. That is, he has ejaculated 2 days ago. In the slide, you can see that there are many sperm. The count is pretty good, but the motility is also good. Compared to the first sample, there are many more sperm that are moving. Now, there were again studies conducted on many men, and it was noticed that a healthy ejaculation frequency of 2 to 3 times per week is good for reproductive health to maintain the counts and the motility of the sperm. So I'd like to say to all the couples who are trying to conceive, maintaining a healthy ejaculation frequency, even by masturbation, is good for your reproductive health. And repeated ejaculations are not sperm killers. They're not going to decrease your chance of conceiving. And I wish you all the best.